Hi everyone, Kevin Williams along with Bob Batters in this week's Shore Sports Network Lacrosse Report, brought to you by Rothman at Brielle. And Bob, the weather has warmed up. We're at that point in the season where the games are becoming bigger and bigger, and the players have become bigger and bigger. So let's kind of start where we kind of focused on a lot the last time we chatted, and that is Kenyon Burch, who with another unbelievable performance yesterday is closing in on a state milestone, one you predicted a while back.
Yeah, the goals have been coming, the points I should say, have been coming in bunches. It's been that way since he stepped on a lacrosse field. And with a huge game yesterday in a win over Red Bank Catholic, 9 goals, 3 assists, Burch is now 2 points away from breaking the state's all-time record of 468, set by Matt Poske of A.L. Johnson in 2002. It's a record at the time where, Kevin, I'm sure a lot of people are like, there's no way this thing's going to be broken. But you know, as the old saying goes, records are made to be broken. And along came a player named Kenyon Burch, and you know, 2 points away. So you got to imagine it's probably going to come in their next game, which, oh, by the way, is a huge one on Saturday at Manasquan against Rumson Fairhaven. That will decide the Class B North title. Two rivals. They've met in the Shore Conference tournament. They've met in the states before. They did not meet last year, and now that rivalry will be renewed, as they're now part of the same division. So certainly a huge one going down on Broad Street on Saturday.
And that's a great setting to set a record. I'm sure everyone involved with Manasquan would like to get that one over early and then move on and focus on the game. But there'll be a share of people there who are just hoping to see Kenyon Burch break that record early.
Yeah, it's a huge record, obviously. And then after that, he'll have the goals record, really the last record in his sights to be broken. And he's well on his way to doing that as well. Just, it's incredible to watch and see history be chased.
Long way to go, but everything you said about Manasquan when we did this early in the season has so far come true. It seems like Manasquan and CBA are clearly the powers in the Shore Conference, but after that, tremendous parity is set in.
Really, that's been kind of the theme of the Shore. You have Manasquan at the top, and Manasquan had a huge, you know, win, an 11-goal win over CBA, and CBA has beaten everybody else they've played within the Shore. After that, you know, from 3 on down to maybe even the 12th, 13th ranked teams in the Shore, if we went that far, could probably all beat each other on any single day. We saw that. Wall had a big 10-9 overtime victory over Rumson Fairhaven. First time Wall's beaten Rumson in its program history, and that win came after 2, you know, kind of close losses last season that Wall had. So they were geared up for that one. They got a huge win. So you say, okay, Wall has kind of ascended to that number 3 spot. Nope, they're not safe either. Red Bank Catholic upsets Wall 14-13, you know, last week. So that kind of just illustrates what we're looking at here. You have the teams in, you know, Howell, you know, with a win over Friel Township with a win over Southern. Toms Earth beats Howell. Southern beats Toms Earth North. I mean, you see how you can't even follow it. We have triangles and quadrangles, and it's kind of come down to who's playing well on that given day. It's going to make for a very interesting Shore Conference tournament. And I think, obviously, Manasquan is at the top, and even CBA, as we mentioned, and I still think Rumson will be there at the end as a very tough out. But we're going to see some games in the rest of the regular season and certainly in the Shore Conference tournament that you don't know who's going to beat who. You walk into that field, and there's a good chance you're going to see a very competitive game that's going to come down to the wire.
Well, while a lot of attention this weekend will be focused on Manasquan and Rumson, there's another game that will decide a division title between a couple of undefeated teams, maybe flying under the radar a little bit, although you have one ranked pretty high right now, and that is Shore Regional and Lacey.
A big game in Class B South. That's a game that's going to decide that division title. Unfortunately, it does fall on the same day, Saturday, as Manasquan Rumson, so more eyes certainly will be on that matchup. But Shore Regional, they've been number 4 in our top 10 since the start of the year. They haven't moved. The move to B South has hurt the Blue Devils a little bit. That's a very top-heavy division, and it has been for many years, even when it was Manasquan and Wall at the top. The Blue Devils just haven't had that big opportunity yet, but they've just been blowing teams out. They're averaging around 15, 16 goals per game. Gil Goldsmith, an outstanding midfielder, is kind of the leader of that team, but Jake Turner, Tom Bacco, you know, they have a ton of guys on that team who can score. Scotty Sirianni in goal has had a very good year. And they're undefeated, and guess what? So is Lacey. And the Lions kind of in that same mold. Undefeated, not ranked like Shore is, but certainly that opportunity is going to come this Saturday. Lions coming off a very impressive 12-5 win over Jackson Memorial, where they were up 9-0 in the third quarter. First time I got to see Lacey all season, and certainly came away very impressed. So You have a two division title games on Saturday, and they're both going to be big ones. One in Monmouth County, and then one down at Forked River in Ocean County. And that's something the Lions certainly have been looking forward to for a long time. Those two teams met last season in a non-divisional game. Shore was up big. Lacey had this insane rally to come back, tied at 13, and then Shore won 14-13 in overtime. So a lot of the same players back on both teams, so I think that's going to be a really good one if you're down in Ocean County, game to check out on Saturday.
And Lacey's chance to earn their way into the top 10 with a win there, right? No doubt about that.
You win that game, yeah, you're getting into the top 10 and probably the top 5 for sure.
How about another team that just a couple of years ago was not even on the radar, but certainly has turned their program around and is having another fine season? That's Middletown South.
Yeah, the Eagles had a breakout season in 2018, finishing 15-4, and they've come into this season and done the exact same thing, taking off, starting where they left off, they're out 9-2, I believe, with a nice 13-5 win over Howell yesterday. They're on track to win another Class A North Public Division title, which they did last year, finishing only behind CBA. And very impressive, as you said, 3-4 years ago, that was a team at the bottom, not just of the Shore, but of that division, just trying to build something. In comes head coach Rob Grella, who is, well-versed, certainly in the game, came in with a lot of, accolades, won a Division III national championship at the women's level in college. So obviously he comes in knowing full well what he's doing. And, that brand of lacrosse that he's tried to preach and cultivate at Middletown South has really taken hold. It's a physical team. They're probably the most physical team you're going to see all year in the Shore Conference, led by Matt Tardy, who, of course, we know from his football exploits as an outstanding linebacker, Connor Ard, Jason Allen, Shane Murphy in goal. And they're a good team. They're ranked number 6 in our top 10 now, and they only have losses to CBA and Manaswan. So they've beaten everyone else they should, and that's probably not something you could have, foreseen just a few years ago. But Middletown South, they're a public school here to stay now, and I think it's only going to get better for the Eagles going forward.
And while I have you, some props for our windmill team of the week this week, Freehold Township earned the honor, and they'll get to eat some hot dogs thanks to that.
The Patriots with a really nice week last week. They went 3-0, the big one being a 7-4 victory over St. John Vianney. Kind of an up-and-down season it was up to that point for Freehold Township. Some good wins, some tough losses in 1-2 goal games, and they finally put together, really was their most complete game of the season. So they're feeling good now. They're riding a nice win streak. I believe it's up to 4 or 5 games now, and they're looking to stay hot heading into the Shore Conference tournament and then eventually the NJSIAA playoffs.
Just don't eat the hot dogs before a game, right?
It's not one of those things. You don't go to windmill before the game. You go after the big win.
That's Bob Batters, of course. If you want to follow lacrosse, he is the guy to follow. You see him every day on shoresportsnetwork.com. Want to thank our friends Rothman at Briel for supporting our coverage of Shore Conference High School Lacrosse. We'll be back at some time in the next week or so. For Bob Batters, I'm Kevin Williams. Again, 24/7, check out shoresportsnetwork.com.